Again, it's been a very crazy day. The joyous feeling in the air when rain falls on a sunny day.
Happy, yeah, 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 yeah. Let the stars, let the roads.
Enjoy life's little pleasures with Maltina. Maltina, share happiness.
This is Hymnodia. It is widely believed that starting your day with a workout, among other things, improves your mood, boosts your energy, and improves mental clarity. In the Hymnstitute, morning workout is a highly revered tradition, regularly observed by Hymntestants before breakfast. Joy and excitement are always obvious as Hymntestants depart the Hymnstitute weekly in high spirit for their stage performance. It was an evening of original compositions which saw the Hymntestants enjoying their own compositions. The tunes and the atmosphere were clearly reflective of the theme, A Prayer for Our World.
For thy mercy seat.
The originality and ingenuity of the Hymntestants in the overall presentation was exceptional. This led to the judges and faculty's decision to declare a week of no probation for all. The music director of the Hymnstitute, Shewu Waje, conveyed this joyful news in a dramatic twist last stanza.
On behalf of the judges and faculty, because of the originality and ingenuity in the hymns performed today, we'd like everyone to be exempt from probation tonight. Congratulations, Hymntestants. Signed, music director.
This cheering news was too good to be true. What actually inspired the Hymntestants in the compositions of those beautiful hymns and tunes? For the faculty, much may have gone in to achieve this feat.
There are different perspectives to hymn writing. There's a spiritual perspective, there's a poetic perspective, and of course there's a musical perspective. So we took them through all these different perspectives. You know, the spiritual perspective, what makes a good hymn, a good one from the spiritual perspectives? What are the things that you need to put in, you know, in terms of the spirit of writing a good hymn? You know, at the end of the day, it's all about God. By the time we finally gave them, you know, the task, that they, you know, I mean, the task of the last stanza in which they were to write and perform their own hymns, I'm not surprised that they came up with the quality of hymns from all the different perspectives of hymn writing that they came up with. I'm not surprised at all.
I connected to it more than I have ever connected to any other hymn. So it felt different and more deep than I felt in this competition in Hymnodia this year. So I really don't know what happened. I don't know how it happened, but I just know I did everything from my heart and it ended up working out well. So maybe that's the strategy now, just doing things from my heart, not caring what is happening around me, but just doing it straight from my heart.
You know, it's been a very tough time for everybody. So I just thought to pen down my emotions and, you know, my thoughts into words, consequently into a hymn.
I think I sang my heart, I sang what I wrote, and I felt happy singing a hymn composed by myself. You know, I think that was the joy I derived from that.
Quite frankly, I was really concerned about the future of my son because I have a 9-month-old baby boy, and I'm really concerned about the future of this present generation. You know, because this pandemic really changed the entire globe.
Even in the institute before we left, I rehearsed and it was fine. Only for me to get there and I felt a crack. My voice, but I still performed it all the same, so I felt bad afterwards, but I got some words of encouragement from my fellow contestants, and I just waited for the results.
It was a wonderful one, with the highlight of the day. Everyone had to go home smiling. It was a wonderful experience in the last hour.
So my hymn was more of a prayer that God should, you know, heal our land, God should come to our rescue, you know, and make everything normal. So it was just to say a word of prayer to the world.
The hymnviction of Enenche further reduced the number of hymntestants by one.
Well, participating in a Hymnodia Season 2 gave me an opportunity to work on my weaknesses and then build on my strengths. Before now, I was already a budding composer. I was also a choir master, but I never knew I could come up with amazing arrangements in the twinkle of an eye. But my participation in Hymnodia helped me, pushed me a little bit further. So I can say participating in Hymnodia Season 2 has made me a better person, a better musician. I now know better how to relate with persons. I've made new friends from Hymnodia, and I'm sure that I'll be maintaining all those relationships for the rest of my life.
Back in the Hymnstitute, the excitement of arrival surpassed that of the departure. Apart from the hymn victor Enenche, all hymntestants returned to the Hymnstitute with a clean bill, as no one was placed on probation. Every hymn-victored hymntestant has the duty of removing one's own picture from the Hymnstitute Hall of Fame. This time around, it's Enenche's turn to perform this painful task.
So, this is the point where you get to pull yours down. Oof. Just take your time and take it all in. Wow. This is you, number 15. You were blessed in different ways, because in season one you were here, but you needed to pursue something bigger, and you acquired that and you came back. And this, on behalf of everyone here, the faculty, the producers, and of course the viewers out there, we want to say all the very best. I'm sure they will run into you someday. Please share your knowledge with everyone. I'm going to leave you here to enjoy the moment, savor it, and all the best.
Thank you.
God bless you.
This period that is Jacob is going. But we know is as people are leaving, it means that we have lesser time to spend in the institute. So definitely we would still meet very soon. So don't worry. That's the only consolation we have, that after people leave the institute, there's still Nigeria in general to be seen ourselves, no matter where we are. So we're fine. We'll all be fine.
A lot of things that we miss about him, the fact that he gives medical advice, the fact that he always has one thing to contribute to every topic. So he's very, very smart.
Yes, it's a competition, but we've been able to bond in such a way that we're now looking at each other as family, you know, like we're brothers and sisters.
It was fun to talk with him. You always enlighten us on things that we didn't even know.
At the Himstitute, learning never stops. Over the week, a motivational speaker and author, Azu Arinze, was guest to the Himtestants. His role mission was to encourage Himtestants to always believe in themselves and stay focused regardless of the situation.
The advice and the story there is that you must never give up. You know, because most times we look at just what is happening now. We can't tell what the future holds. So
perhaps that was the tonic the Himtestants needed to boost their morale as they listened with rapt attention. This is Himnodia Magazine Show. As usual, Himtestants met for worship service Sunday morning. It was another opportunity to celebrate God for His goodness. Word of exhortation was given by Yinka.
We have our differences. Even siblings have their differences. And this, where struck me most is the part that says, love does not envy. Now this also speaks to me. I'm not just a better person.
You know, Echezona said the closing prayer.
Thank you for the service. Thank you for your lessons.
In the Himstitute, the tenure of an elected stanza leader runs for a week. With the expiration of Ogochukwu's tenure, another election was conducted. Steve got the highest number of total votes cast and was declared the new stanza leader. Steve accepted his new role and called for cooperation from his colleagues.
So, I'll do my best to serve everyone better. Thank you.
Himnodia is all about hymns and creating of new hymns. What about hymns? What makes hymns different from other classes of songs? What does hymn mean to the Himtestants?
For me, it is one of the ways that I get connected to God, and I have that deep, deep connection, you know, and I'm able to communicate with God and let Him know exactly how I feel.
The lyrics of hymns, when you look at them, they will open your eyes to a whole lot of other realities. How marvelous our God is.
It tells you of your Creator, it tells you the one who made the heavens and earth, tells you the essence of your being, tells you where you're going and where He's taking us. It tells you of your Christian journey or your life on earth, or dealings with your fellow human beings, worship, name it.
There is no, you cannot connect with a hymn. There are hymns of prayer, there are hymns of thanksgiving, there are hymns of supplication, there are hymns of, you know, just anything you want to tell God, there's a particular hymn for it.
Anyhow you want to look at it, if you don't have a close relationship with God, you can't be closer to hymns, you can't find it pleasing to your ears.
I did hymns, like I sang hymns in church, but I didn't look at them like to understand what they meant. I just loved the tunes and then I sang. But when I came to this house, I sat down and I thought to myself, let me even look at this. And when you pick one line of those hymns, you find a whole lot of things. A line of a particular hymn will teach you a whole lot of things. For a musician, hymns can be a source of inspiration, actually. A very, very good source of inspiration.
So my advice to people out there is to actually take a step further in realizing themselves in God, and also get to fellowship, get to feed their souls with those beautiful sounds through hymns. Yeah, because it's also a form of praise, worship, and reverence to God.
So it also shapens the mind of an individual, and I encourage it in schools, at home, wherever.
If you're lagging in any aspect of your life, just like the Bible, open your hymn book, read the lines, sing it out, and you see what will happen.
To me, generally, songs at which I use to communicate with God. Because personally, I prefer to sing rather than just talk.
Theme for this stanza, hymns in mother tongue. Language is a part of cultural identity. The task for the intestines this stanza is to convert a popular hymn into a 3 minutes danceable hymn in their local dialect. How are the hymntestins preparing for this task? Their rehearsal with the band?
I'm not really a good dancer. but I think I've got some moves up my sleeve, so I've already started rehearsing my dance moves. Speaking my language, singing in my language, well, I give credit to my parents because I was born and raised in Lagos. But I did my university days. My university days was in University of Calabar. So I was able to, that was actually what really helped me develop my language even the more, because I was now around people that spoke my language and all that. So I learned a couple of things while I was in school. And I'm really looking forward to this standard.
For the new task, I'm excited about it because it gives me the opportunity to loosen up. It afforded me the chance to dance and, you know, play around while on stage. So I'm excited.
I know my way around my dialect, vernacular singing, my hymns in our hymns in vernacular, and I'm sure, by the grace of God, I'll be well prepared to deliver.
I am very excited about the new task. I was actually waiting for it because it's like my thing. I'm from the Celestial Church of Christ, and you know, these kind of things are just the things that we like to do. So, and I'm very confident with my language. I'm singing in Yoruba, so I'm just ready to bring it to the stage. Because that probation, no, I'm not going back to it.
So I think I'll bring my A game. Not I think, I know I'll bring my A game in this because I'm comfortable with it. And God being my help, I'll try my best. I'll try my best and I'll do what I can do to please myself, to please the judges, and to please my God.
This is Hymnodia Magazine Show. Are you a hymn lover? Log on to our Instagram page and get involved in I Love Hymns Challenge, currently ongoing, and stand a chance to win a special gift from Hymnodia and a pass to the Hymncert 2020. Let's join the Dean and hear what he has to say on the season so far and what we should be expecting on the stanzas ahead.
I'm sure you're all wondering what I'm doing on the drums today. It's good to have you again. It's Dean Benneth. And my question to you is this. Did you enjoy the last stanza? It was an absolute breeze having our contestants put their own beautiful imagination and intelligence into hymn writing. Whose hymn did you enjoy the most? For the night, I think the judges were spot on to say that Jason's hymn was the most beautiful. I mean, it conveyed a prayer, a cry for help, and the fact that we need God in our lives. Jason, well done. And to all the other hymn contestants, want to say congratulations to you because you have printed your names in the sands of time in terms of hymn writing. Unfortunately, Enenche will not be joining the bandwagon in the new stanza. And what is the theme? They get to write hymns in their mother tongues. Is it in Hausa? Is it in Yoruba? Is it in Igbo? Is it in TV? Or do you want to write it in Ibibio or Efik? Whichever one it is, the hymn contestants will be battling it this new stanza in terms of hymns in their mother tongue. It is indeed a pleasure to be here at the Institute sharing this wonderful experience with you. And for all of you out there, anticipate something absolutely beautiful in hymns in our mother tongue. Who is going to be the big surprise for this stanza? Time will tell, and your votes will also tell. Oh yes, by the way, we also would like to thank judges for giving us the opportunity, especially to the hymn contestants, for not being on probation for possible hymn eviction for the last stanza. That is a very rare gift. In closing, I want to share this wonderful hymn with you in the indigenous language of Yoruba. My faith looks up to thee. Igbagbo mi wo iwo dagutan olugbala jogbo adura mi kese mi gbogbo lo ke Tony Losh CJ Tire From the Hymn Institute, we want to say God bless and see you again.
Feels good to see your face again. It's been a very crazy day. The joyous feeling in the air when rain falls on a sunny day.
Happy, yeah, 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 yeah. Let the stars, let the roll.
I was born to be happy.
Enjoy life's little pleasures with Maltina. Maltina, share happiness.
This is Hymnodia. While we look forward to another stanza for another mind-blowing hymnal renditions, you can catch up with the previous episodes on the show and join the interesting conversation on our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. at Hymnodia HQ. Feel free also to send us your comments and feedback on our social media handles by email to info@hymnodiahq.org. You can also watch, like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, www.youtube.com/hymnodiahq. The surprise never ends. Tension and momentum are getting higher as the show gets better and hotter. Who will eventually become the ultimate winner of Hymnodia Season 2? You will find out. This is Hymnodia, the art of worship. See you next stanza.